Hi, I just wanted to thank you for allowing me to come here tonight and talk to you guys at the PTSO. For those of you that don't know, my name is Jennifer Campbell, and I'm the new principal at Sturgeon High School. Today, I just wanted to talk to you about some changes that are happening at the Sturgeon High School, as well as some of the updates that we are really excited about. So today, we're gonna talk about four different things. We're gonna talk about some updates that we have to our facilities. We're gonna talk about our new cell phone policy. We're gonna talk about changes in seminar, as well as something we're really excited about, and that's our new student leadership team. So we do have some facility updates. As you know, we had a recent bond issue and we're able to update a lot of different things at the high school, as well as at the middle school and the elementary school buildings. After we finished those, we also got a couple grants. We were fortunate enough to also get a couple of donations. So we've updated three more things since finishing everything with the bond project. And those updates include, we now have new LED lights throughout the building. We were able to go through a special process where we got a rebate for putting in the LED lights. So they started over at the elementary and the middle school buildings and then moved out to the high school. And that project was completed in October of 2018. We also installed new U-bolts in all the classrooms, not only here at the high school, but also in the middle school and the elementary building. And then something that everyone is really excited about, I can't wait for the community to see it, we just completed a new gym floor in December. And when we have homecoming next week, everyone will get to see the gym floor in person for the first time. So here's a picture of the new LED lights. I know it's kind of hard to see, but if you look in every classroom, as well as in the hall, the cafeteria, and the gym, we have new LED lights. These lights are brighter, but we were also able to lower the number of lights in every classroom. So because of that, we have increased efficiency, and it will also lower the utility cost here at the high school, which is awesome. So we're really excited to get that done in October. The next picture I wanted to show you is of the new U-bolts. So at the high school, we're really fortunate. We have new locks attached to our doors already so that you can lock your door from the inside. Just by turning the knob instead of having to use a key. So this is just added security. This is a U-bolt. As you can see, it's at the bottom of the door. You lift this white piece up, slide it over, and then slide it into this blue piece. So if someone were to try to open the door, even if it were unlocked, the door will only open about an inch, maybe a little less. So like I said, it's an added security feature. If, heaven forbid, someone were to get into the school, if you weren't able to get the door locked in time, you could use the U-bolt, or you could have both, which again just increases student safety. And these, like I said, are at all the schools' buildings within the district. The last thing, he said something we're all really excited about, since our gym is such a source of community pride for us, we put in a new gym floor through a donation from the Friends of Sturgeon Girls Basketball. They raised about $14,000 2 years ago and put in the new scoreboard and the lights behind the backboard of the basket. And then this year, they raised about $12,000 and helped purchase the new gym floor. So if you look, it's now darker in the behind the three-court line and then lighter throughout the rest of the gym. It's really shiny and sparkly if you go see it in person. We have new blue trim around the entire baseline. And then we have Sturgeon Bulldogs with the full body of the Bulldog in the middle. So we're really excited. We're gonna be able to hold a few more events at the high school than we were, and things like homecoming, the Sturgeon tournament, graduation, concerts. It's just gonna look awesome on our new floor. So we were really excited about the fact that Sturgeon girls basketball team was able to donate that money to us. So the next thing I'm gonna talk to you about is the new cell phone policy here at the high school. We had a meeting with the students today. I met with each class to talk to them about the changes so that they were aware, as the cell phone policy affects them more than anyone. So the new policy, and I'm gonna have to go over here to click this. This is the presentation that I showed to the students. So we tweak the policy every year, but this new policy is really, like I said, to help limit the distractions that students have while they're at school. So we're asking that upon entering the classroom, students silent their phone. They are allowed to have their phones with them, but we ask that they put them on silent and that they either put them into their bags, their purses, or they put them into these cell phone caddies that we have bought for every classroom. And they look a lot like the old caddies that we use for calculators. So each student will be assigned a number. If they don't want to put their phone in their backpack or in their purse, they can put it into the caddy and it will remain there until the end of the class. There will be time for students to get them out at the end of class, but for students who do not participate in doing this and their cell phone disrupts the class, they're going to be subject to the new cell phone and smart device insubordination policy. And that's on page 52 of your handbook. Basically, for your first offense of having your cell phone out, you're going to get 1 day of ACP. For those of you that don't know, ACP stands for Alternative Classroom Placement. It's the same as ISS back in our day, which stood for in-school suspension. So the first offense is 1 day of ACP. Second offense would be 3 days. Third offense would be 5 days. And then the fourth offense would be 3 days of out-of-school suspension. The consequences have been bumped up from last year to this year. And the reason for that is we've seen an increase in cell phone violations. Students have said that the consequences is minor enough that they don't mind spending some time in detention. They don't mind spending time doing those types of things. And so we were hoping that by removing them from school for an entire day, that it would help limit some of those violations. We are encouraging teachers to give students a warning before they write them up so that a student has their chance to turn off their cell phone or a chance to put their phone away. But we would like to see those cell phone violations go down because the most important thing to us is obviously student instruction, and it's hard for them to learn if they're on their cell phones. Students will be given time to get their phones at the end of class. Like I said, if a student leaves their phone, they're going to be allowed to come back and get it. There'll also be times within the classroom that we encourage the use of technology, so students will be allowed to get on their phone and use it to complete projects or use it to do different things. As long as it's okay by the teacher, it's fine for them to be on their phones to complete school projects. And we are not responsible if anything happens to the phone, if it's lost, stolen, or damaged. So we're really encouraging students to make sure that they're putting their phones in a safe place so that if something does happen to them, they know that we as the school are not responsible. So that's our new cell phone policy. It's very similar to the old one. The big change is that there is an increase in consequence if you are caught violating the policy. So, and then like I said, we just want students to be able to learn. A lot of research shows that if you can limit the use of cell phones, that a lot of times test scores and grades in individual classes go up, and that is of course our goal. The next thing that I'm gonna talk to you about is our changes in seminar. Seminar is the 30 minutes that we dedicated at the end of the day to address student needs. So for the last 4 years, every high school student has a 30-minute seminar at the end of the day. It allows students to work on assignments, and it also allows teachers to provide individualized instruction to students. In the past, seminar was a lot more like a study hall. Students had time to work on assignments, but we found that the following things were happening. Many students, regardless of what their grades were, did not use the time provided to work on school assignments. A lot of them wanted to do other things. We found that high-achieving students didn't really need the time. They don't need an extra 30 minutes to work on their assignments. They're getting them done at home. They're getting them done in class. So it was kind of a wasted 30 minutes for them. We also found with our lower-achieving students, students that did struggle academically, that they couldn't access the help that they needed during that period. They weren't placed with teachers, that they were struggling in their classes. They weren't able to get help even if they would have used it. There was also no system in place for students who needed enrichment, who were already doing really well in classes and could do above and beyond, or students that needed intervention. So what we started to do was revise seminar, and now students, after 5 weeks, will be placed either in blue level, silver level, or white level. So if you're on blue level, you have a 3.75 GPA, you have two or fewer absences during that time period, you have one or fewer tardies during that time period, you have no disciplinary referrals, and you have no grades below a 70%. And that would place you on blue level for that cycle. If you're on blue level, you're given a blue card. And with that card, you can go to different areas within the school. So you can go to the gym, you can go to the computer lab, you can go to the commons where you can get on your cell phone, you can go to the library, you can go to the art room. So you have a bit more freedom. We simply ask students to check in with their teacher, and then they sign in at whatever location they choose to spend their time at during seminar. Silver level, Our students who have no grades below a 70%, but they don't meet the other criteria that would put them on blue level, these students utilize seminar as though it were a study hall. So it stays the same for them. White level is students that have grades below a 70%. If you're a white level student, you either have missing assignments or you have work that you need to make up. All right. You also might have a parent who requests that their child's put on white level so they can get a little bit of extra help. So white level students will conference with the corresponding teachers. So if you were failing language arts, you would talk to your language arts teacher and you're going to set up an intervention schedule for you to come to their seminar class to get the individual help that you need. Once your grades have gone up, the teachers can move you back to silver level and seminar will become like a study hall for you again. We found that by doing this, the students that don't need help in seminar can be on blue level. Like I said, they can have a little bit more freedom. And then the students that are struggling academically can get the help that they need. We implemented this very recently, and so far the students have really enjoyed it. The last thing that I wanted to talk to you about is something that we're very excited about. We're getting ready to start it now, is the student leadership team. So within the student leadership team, two students from every grade are going to be asked to serve on this team. The team's going to meet twice a month, and they're going to address issues facing the school. We're going to let them decide what issues that they want to address as we get going. The first issue that we're going to look at, as a staff, we talked about something we noticed is that we don't really have a lot of students participating in things. We don't have a lot of students at the games that are just there to watch the games. We don't have students at the school play. We don't have students that go to the band meets and the choir meets. And we really kind of want to figure out what we can do to improve student involvement and participation in those things. How can we get more students interested in these types of activities? As a faculty, we've tried a lot of different things and none of them have seemed to work. So we're hoping that we can kind of get some advice from the students and get their perspective and see what they think about kind of what's going on at the school so that we can change the school climate. We are in the process of selecting that student leadership team right now, talking to students and seeing who would like to be involved. And then we are going to start meetings next month. I think it's a really great way to get the students involved and gain knowledge from their perspective and kind of give them some engagement within the school so that they can really feel like they're a part of things. So those are the changes that we have going on right now at Sturgeon High School. Again, I really appreciate you guys allowing me to come and speak. Is there anyone that has any questions?
Yes, I have a couple of questions if you have a minute or two.
Sure.
With regard to the cell phone policy, what concerns have been expressed by the parents of these children?
We have had some parent concerns. The major parent concern is, what if I need to get a hold of my child? Obviously, we want parents to be able to get a hold of their children if it is an emergency. We do ask if you need to get a hold of them in an emergency situation that you call the school, and then Miss Carroll or Mr. Cruz or whoever's man in the office at that point can come and get the student and address the issue with them. If it's something like you just need them to pick something up after school or you just need them to do something like that, it's fine to send them a text or call them. Just know that they're not going to be able to respond immediately to those text messages or those phone calls until they're at passing time or they're at lunch, and that's a time where they can use their cell phone. So parents have been concerned about, can we talk to our child during the school day? Of course. We just want to make sure that those conversations are occurring outside of class time.
Well, one final question. I appreciate that answer. I'm very excited about the student leadership team. Can you tell us, how are students selected for that program?
So what we did is we asked teachers to nominate students that they thought would do a good job, kids that they think are would be interested in kind of dealing with these issues, and then kids that they think the other students would listen to and follow and kind of take some advice from. So we compiled a list, and then we looked at who the teachers voted for, and we're able to narrow it down to two or three students per grade. We're then calling those students in and asking them if it's something they're interested in, because we want students on the team that are interested in being on the team. So like I said, we have the list of the students that teachers have selected, and we've started that interview process to see if they are in fact interested. And so there should be 8 students that make up that leadership team, 2 from every grade. So, and like I said, something that we're very excited about.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Are there any other questions? All right. Thank you. If you have any questions, feel free to send me an email or just call up to the school. I'll be happy to talk to you guys about anything that's